everybody, and welcome back to The Witcher 3, where we're in fairy tale land, and I'm back home from the wilderness for a few days, and I have to worry about moving, so expect videos to be weird for the next month or so. So, anyway, that'll be something I talk about later, probably. For now, we have more important things to do. Can we talk?
This is no time to chat. We must find Joss.
We have to find Joss. We follow the yellow brick road. We fight off pixies. Okay, also...
Unicorns!
What?!
We must catch them. We won't have to walk everywhere then.
Roach?
I call the pink one.
Roach? What? Roach? What? Unicorns? The pink one? What? A rainbow? What? Oh my gosh. Okay, Sienna, you're in the way. I can't get on Roach. The unicorn. Your pink one's over here. Optional, ride the white unicorn.
Exciting, isn't it? Reminds me of my childhood.
Reminds me of something altogether different.
Care to elaborate?
Rather not.
Not the unicorn, please.
What's here? None at all. This is Grant. I'm alright, not in any danger. That's him. Joss. Last, they're going to rip him in
I'm fine. Why was that kid pretending there were no wolves? Ow. Sorry, Roach the Unicorn.
Relax. It's over.
No, it's not. There's more. Another wolf behind you! Ignore him. He always lies.
Aha. Boy who cried wolf. Still does, I suppose. And doesn't. When they actually appear.
The one and only. Listen, you little chit. Jack said you know what's become of his three beads.
I don't know anything! Not one thing! And besides, watch out! Wolves!
Ha! Huh. Okay, we gotta do it in order.
This'll be interesting. Right, let's get to it. Let's say for a minute you know what happened to the red bean. Where wouldn't it be?
For certain, no one swallowed it. Oh no, definitely not that.
All the kids sound the same.
But say someone didn't. Who would it be that didn't swallow it?
A human. The most human human in the land of a thousand fables. Everyone! Wolves! Run!
What? So who's the most human-y human?
Bet you haven't heard what happened to the blue bean. Maybe? Not at all? Right?
I've heard it lies about somewhere, out in the open.
Just like that? No one guarding it?
Nobody! Three times over! Help! Wolves!
Sorry about that. I hate it when it does that stupid little Alienware notification. It's like, do you not want me to remind you ever again? And I'm like, no, I don't want you to remind me ever again. And it still does. So that's cool. This is interesting. Yeah, it's pretty easy to get something out of a habitual, like one that, a liar that knows the truth, you know? You just have to go about it a little bit backwards.
Yellow bean. Don't know a thing about it, right?
Somewhere very, and I mean very deep. So deep, in fact, it's completely underground.
And who has it?
A bold farmhand, who in no way and not at all awaits someone. Not in the slightest. Good folk! Wolf!
Say that word one more time and I'll chop you up. Feed you to the fishes. Understood?
I think he told us... Because she asked a direct question, and he answered it. So it was... So that was a lie. I don't know.
All right, we should go.
Watch out for wolves!
She's gonna chop you up.
Tough to talk to, that one.
Was it, though?
You need merely remember he always lies, or more precisely, rehearses the truth.
Mm-hmm. Where to now?
I'm not sure. You should visit some of the other fables, the meaty ones, that is. Perhaps then Joss's hints will make more sense. It's just a few. Red Riding Hood, Piglets and Bears, the Ring of Each, and Goldilocks, of course. Then Longlocks, and a little lass who sells flint.
Ah, fine. Let's get to work.
Okay, so this is really interesting. For this DLC, they,
Incredible. You must have loved this place.
I did at first. But children get bored quickly. Even tea parties with a whole cackle of princesses eventually turn dull and routine.
What did you do then?
Dropped a duck egg in the swan's nest once, that sort of thing. Stole the pea out from under the princess, who sleeps to this day, I think.
She like, tortured him. There's a naked guy! But anyway...
Oh, look! The Emperor of Nilfgaard! He's come out to show off his new robe.
Oh my gosh! The invisible...
Stunning, are they not? My new robe's absolutely stunning.
Oh my gosh, how many fairy tales are in this place? Anyway, I just think it's really cool that, like, we went to this twist, sort of a twisted fairy tale land, but we also had the option of going to what I, sort of to me, sounds like a very Cthulian vampire-esque, like, Dark Lord thing, you know? Like, we had two options, and, like, I'm kind of intrigued. Like, I wonder what would have happened if we'd have done the other route, you know? This is interesting. So, they gave you, like, two whole stories you could do. That's really cool. All right, which is the closest? Talk to Longlocks. Okay. No. Oh, I cannot. I have no map. Well, everything's over here, so we'll go this way. Who's in the tower? Longlocks? I bet you Longlocks is in the tower. It's Rapunzel, I bet. Oh, that's right. Wait. Oh, wrong button. Oh, I need to do my meditation. The meditation where I don't meditate. Pixies, shoot. They were... It's been a while. Are they... Relics? No, specters. They're not specters. They're not vampires. Cursed ones? No. Hybrids? No. Not insectoids. Necrophage, Ogroid, relics. I should play Elite Dangerous. I own it. Never played it. Well, I started to, but it was like, Pixies are Elementia. I should probably remember that. Because I'm probably gonna encounter them a lot. See, this is, this story, I mean, the other one with the vampire lore would probably be pretty cool, but, really? What? Why can't I? Oh, that's my steel sword. Okay, for some reason I thought that was the other way around, that was the steel sword, but nope. You're not supposed to attack them. Okay, that was fast. Let's go see Longlocks.
This Longlocks tower?
Indeed. It's even taller than I remember.
Wait. What Joss said about the third beam, remember?
In the possession of a bold farmhand somewhere deep beneath the ground. Yes, this must be it. Let's go. It always grapple up her braid in the past, but I don't see it anywhere.
We'll find another way up.
Looks like there's stairs.
Could pull myself up here, and I'll have to make that jump.
If you say so, I shall wait down here if it's all the same. Climbing's not my strong.
Oh boy, somebody died. Could grapple up where, you fool? Oh my god. To look up a video.
Prince's corpse. Tried to free Longlocks, but fell and broke his neck.
Yep. Something's up. And why are there stairs? Like, wait. Is that something? No? Okay. Wow, look at the pretty hills! Go in here? Oh, yep. It's okay, girl. Why she's like, it's somewhere very deep. Oh, that's right. Okay, so he's the opposite of what everything he said. I thought we were asking him opposite questions. I see. I thought we were asking him opposite questions, but what he did was actually give us clues. So he wasn't telling us the truth. He was telling us the lie. So a bald farmer, so that would be a very long-haired princess. A girl, not a boy, and not a farmer, but a princess, who is somewhere very, very, very deep, but actually very, very, very tall. Okay, I see. Oh boy. Oh girl. I'm worried. Hold on, this seems like one of those gonna be a big, you know, choicey choice thing. Geralt's like, bleh, frozen in place. Okay. Sneaky! Thought she was gonna be in there. She killed herself with her own hair. That's disgusting. Please don't.
Oh boy! Oh boy! Oh my gosh!
Whoo! That scared the crap out of me. I knew it was gonna happen, but it still scared the crap out of me. Wow, that's really depressing. Like, wow. Like, I can't believe, like, I know it's like a fairy tale world, like, it's an illusion, but, like, they're like, I don't know, like, that's really sad. I'm like, crap, I didn't meditate! Crap. I guess we'll do that one. I already have these active. Oh, okay. Where's my specter? This one's Spectre, yeah. Nope. You're so creepy looking! Moving around, it's so creepy. while ago. So, is this something... Like, did the prince see this and, like, jump off and kill himself? Or was he pushed off by the specter? That's really sad. Her whole little story is very sad.
Stunk to climb all that way for nothing.
That's really rude, Geralt. Magic food. I'll take some magic food. There's a dead girl right here. Well, that was easy. Can I jump off? I want to. Assassin's Creed!
Yay!
We Assassin's Creed'd it! Hi.
So?
Got the bean, but long logs. Seems she got sick of waiting for a knight in shining armor.
Can you blame her? Men these days, dandies and fops all.
That way you cozied up to a vampire?
Dandruff was a tool, and only a tool.
Too bad he didn't know that.
I trust no one. Learned that long ago. Now it's his turn.
I see.
To use him. Was that your plan from the start?
No. At first, I was simply intrigued. Do you know the story? It was in Matina, a few years
ago. This is cool.
I'd gone there to pass some loot off to a fence I know. We were hashing out the terms when in walked Detlaf. He said he'd come to sell a silver candlestick. He gripped it through a cloth. That caught my eye. I followed him out, observed him from a distance, but he caught on quickly.
Yeah, superhuman senses will do that.
He turned down a blind alley. I followed. He jumped out from behind a crate, baring his teeth. I suppose he'd wanted to frighten me. Alas, he didn't in the least. After all, I'm a monster too, am I not?
Oh, interesting. Interesting perspective there.
A higher vampire and you were unimpressed? Don't know if that's brave or just plain foolish.
I've always had a way with ostensibly dangerous, quiet types.
That's supposed to be about me, too?
Ugh, bother. I hate to disappoint you, Geralt, but your belly button is not the center of the... You do remind me of him a bit. Stifling all emotions inside you. Ever feigning indifference.
He's yawning.
You see, when I met Detlaf, I...
Oh, okay, the actual story.
Intuition that he meant me no harm. That he was trying to frighten me off, for he, too, was scared. Now, do you understand?
I guess.
Geralt! I want to shake him sometimes.
What happened then?
We talked, then met up once, twice, three times. Enough that he became infatuated. I truly enjoyed it at first. But only at first. He did not love like a man. But like an animal, madly, deeply, unconditionally, wildly. To return such a feeling, anyone would be hard-pressed. Let alone someone as twisted as I am.
So there came a day you just up and disappeared.
Yes. There was no other way. Let's just be friends, or I don't deserve you. He'd never have understood that sort of thing.
It's true.
But then,
she had him pegged.
I decided to return, clean up some old affairs. I remembered him and concluded he could still be of use.
Playing with fire, that.
Definitely. And either I'll get burned or I'll burn all else down. No other options.
Interesting. I told you she wanted to burn everything. I don't know why she's, like, pretending to care about the citizens. I don't know. I'm torn on this woman. I don't really like. I think I've kind of got her pegged, but at the same time, like, it's she's very complicated, complex personally, because of everything she's been through and the way she's dealt with it. She's a hard woman. And someone like Detlef, like, did you see the way when he was checking her for wounds, he just, like, walked up to her and, like, grabbed her face and turned her side to side, like, not acting like she was an autonomous being in some ways, like, that sort of a thing. That's kind of, I don't know if the developers just didn't know, and they just, or whatever, but, like, that sort of indicates that the guy sees the woman as, like, his property, and he's checking for, you know, anything that's gone wrong, you know? And, like, I understand Detlef may love her, you know, but, like, it's a different sort of love than one she can return. And a woman as free and hard-headed as she is, like, she's all about her freedom. Like, all about her doing her own thing, you know? And someone like Detlef would smother her. Like, I get it 100%. Like, I'm not saying it very well, but I get it. Like, someone who loves that much would be frightening for someone like her. And, but also, like, smothering. It's too much. Like, you can't, that's not actually love. That's, like, obsession. You know, what he has. It's not really love. It's obsession. She doesn't, she can't have that. She's free. She's her own woman. Doesn't need him like he needs her. Because he fell.
Got a history with Detlef now. So this meeting will be different. Not afraid?
I can handle him.
Mm-hmm. Sure about that?
You look at him as a witcher and see a monster. I know what he's really like. You needn't worry. It's time to go. Just a bit more work and we'll be able to say sot off to this fecking fable sphere.
Okay, well, let's go in order then. We'll go see the three little pigs. I'm like waiting for the pixies. Doggy? Doggy, we don't got time.
Watch out, pixies!
Are these actually supposed to be challenging? Because I'm literally one-hitting them. And I know I'm like nearly level 50, but still.
Oh, the three little pigs homes. You know the story, don't you?
I'm the wolf!
He's afraid of the big bad wolf.
Looks like Big Bad's already blown down the houses of straw and sticks. Brick's the only one left.
We should look inside. Remember Joss's words?
One bean lies out in the open, guarded by three nobodies. Yeah, could be it.
So, in a break house, guarded by three pigs? I'm the wolf. I actually am the wolf. This is hilarious. Hi. Oh my gosh, I have to blow the house down. Oh wow, these are big. These are big hitters.
They didn't like.
Oh, what? She's such a swearer. That's not even a word. I forgot to meditate again. It's okay though. I still have the effect. But we need the beast oil. This one? Nope. Relict. Momentia. Beast. Right? Yes. Steel. That's where I put it, right? Yes. Or am I using my... I don't think I am. I think I'm using the silver. I'll just put it on both. Woo! In real life, pigs are not something to mess with. Ooh, oh my gosh, even just, not boars, but wild pigs, like feral pigs. You don't mess with. Oh, we should reach the bestiary entrance. Oh, we killed one, good. What's he saying? The pig's talking. Oh, is that an Asgardian Emperor? Oh, hey, she's right. Is she riding her pink unicorn? Magic dust. Maybe I could use some magic dust. He doesn't look like the Emperor of Nilfgaard. This is remarkably easy.
The big bad witcher huffed and puffed, and look, got a beam.
It cannot be.
What cannot be?
You actually have a sense of humor.
Stunted a bit, but yeah, it's there.
Well, well, aren't you full of surprises?
Stunted a bit,
what
but
else
yeah.
What are you hiding behind that gruff exterior?
Not a bad singer. Do a pretty mean rendition of The Maids of Vicovaro, for instance.
What?
Some other time, maybe.
But here we are chatting away when there's work to do. We must keep looking.
I'm not your type. Actually, I think I am, but I'm not gonna get between you and Detlef, that's for sure.
So, do you like it here?
No. Got a problem with magic in general. Illusions, portals, all that. Don't trust any of it.
A bow of old-fashioned tastes, eh? I like that.
Please. I don't want to be part of your plans. I've already found two beans. I'm a little concerned. I want to talk to the girl who sells flint and visit Grandmama.
How you like that silver?
How you like that silver? I would prefer if they did offer some challenge, because otherwise it's just me flailing and being kind of bored. Okay, this is so cool. I want to be an environmental design artist so bad. I think that's the coolest part of games.
Once upon a time, a terrible dragon attacked Vizima. It took a clever young cobbler to bring about its defeat.
Right. Every now and again, some village idiot tries to imitate him. And I gotta come in to clean up the mess. Just one thing in its gut. A half-digested sheep, stuffed with tar and sulfur. Of course, but no bean.
Does that not disgust you, poking about in a rotting corpse?
Compared to the time I fought a Zeugel in
Vizima. Ooh, I remember that!
Never mind. Don't feel like telling that story again.
I read that in the book. That was very traumatizing for Geralt. So everywhere you go, there's little stories. Aww. Grandmama. I wish I could remember the clues off the top of my head.
Did you like Anna Henrietta?
Do you jest? I adored her. My darling little sis. So adorable. So sweet. Yet when they banished me from the palace, she didn't so much as peek out of the window.
She might not have known. Maybe just couldn't.
And could she also not grant me amnesty when she was crowned? Please.
That's my thing. And she's like, oh, my darling sister. And I'm like, yeah, but you didn't look for her. Oh, hi. I've already eaten and thrown up. I'm trying to talk to the big bad wolf.
Hello? Can we talk?
Schmungoch, my head! Damn it all! I swear that was the last time I drank with Redbeard. Oh, Sianna, a bloody long time it's been. You've changed.
Whereas you, not at all, big bad wolf. Though it seems you've started running with the wrong crowd.
And who should I run with, eh? Thumbelina? One shot and she's under the table.
Meh!
But,
Who's you? Of course, it's Little Red Riding Hood.
You could always have a drink with us.
Oh, what now? Not on your life. I can barely stand, I'm so hungover.
You know what they say about the hair of the dog?
Out of the question! And why must you drink? Do you wish to drown some sorrow? And I don't mean to pry, but you don't look much like a young duchess to me.
They stripped me of my title and birthright, then banished me. A family spat, let's say.
Whew.
Listen, looking for magic beans. Seen any?
I was given one for safekeeping, but...
Where is it? Talk!
Shh, not so loud.
Oh, I can be much louder than this. And resort to other means of persuasion.
Right there, the threats. See Anna to a T. Listen, I exist to restage a fairy tale. If you want to play at it, I'll be happy to oblige. But it won't be easy. The thing is, Little Red Riding Hood's popped her clogs.
Does that mean she's not insane?
A thousand times they cut my gut open, filled it full of rocks and drowned me in the river. So once you stopped coming, I decided to repay the little imp for all her loving labor. Oh. Who now rots at the bottom of the well, she and the hunter, which means we can't play, and I'm under no obligation to talk to you, not about beans, nor anything else. So leave me be. Sod off.
Interesting. So the wolf, in the end was like, I'm done with this.
Wolf's pretty cranky.
Surprised? Think about it. He was cast in the role of the nemesis without ever asking for it.
Thank you.
It's a dog's life, I tell you.
So, what now?
Don't worry. I'll play with him. Or rather, play him. I just need that little red hood. The piece of apparel, that is. Not the poor girl's corpse.
That's a relief.
You wish to help me? Here's your chance. Jump in the well and fish it out. Well, chop chop.
You're gonna wear the decayed hood? That hood probably has, like, nasties on it.
All right. Time to jump in the well.
Break a leg.
Thanks. Okay, so I've had several interruptions, but while we're on this screen, let's read the new bestiary. Why bother with brick? In this climate, even a straw house is nice and cozy. A little pig. The three little pigs are perfect examples of a rather unfortunate phenomenon. Leave even a kind-hearted, warm, naively benign creature to fend for itself, and it won't remain benign for so long. Okay. Spectres. Well, since it seems his hair won't be pulling up any knights in shining armor, might as well put it to some use, the last words of Longlocks. Everyone knows love stories can have tragic endings, but few would think this also applies to princesses from fairy tales created to relive a set happy ending over and over and over again. Longlocks had the misfortune of becoming just such an unlucky tragic heroine. After the Duke's daughters grew up and the Land of a Thousand Fables went feral, Longlocks, whose prince never came and who suffered greatly from her loneliness, decided to hang herself by her own braid. After she died, her ghost stayed to haunt the castle in which she had awaited her suitor. So why didn't the prince come and get her? Ever. What delayed him? Goodbye, pink horse. Here we go. Oh boy. Oh, there's something. Swimming around in there. Let's do... If I can... Do some... Cat... I have 5 potions going right now. Ho-ho! Nice. Oh, she's not in here? She's over here. Easy enough. Oh, it's Sienna upstairs. That's moving around. Oh, so I have to get back out. I was like, how do I get back out? This way. Really that easy? Okay, well now I need to... I thought it was gonna be a little bit longer than that, like a protracted battle or something. Oh!
Any
luck? Oh, hey!
Yep, look what I got.
That would never fit you. Give it to me. How do I look?
Like Little Red Riding Hood?
Not bad. Not bad at all.
Let's Might go as well see be nice. The big bad wolf.
Let me guess. You'll play the granddaughter.
Mm-hmm. And I'm
and
the hunter!
The hunter.
Did you see the horse and the chicken and everything in the back? I think that's like the riddle of trying to get like the horse
you
and the
again?
Dog and the chicken.
I thought that was clear. I will not talk to you if Little Red Riding Hood is not with you.
Not a problem. Sienna can take her place.
What? Very well. It's not as if I can forbid you. Granddaughter, come closer, sweetie.
But Grandmama, what big eyes you have.
They're better to see you with, my dear.
Granny, what big arms you have.
They're better to embrace you with, my dear.
And Grandmama, what big teeth you have. Eh?
They're better to eat you with, my dear.
Butcher you!
Oh, my sword is breaking. Did you die? Or are you
Remember
gonna come back?
Remember what Joss said about the red bean. A human has it, and he definitely didn't swallow it.
Mm-hmm. Gotta open his belly. Bottle caps, fake teeth, a corkscrew. Ah, here it is. Red bean.
Ew.
Ah, at last we have them all.
I wanted to talk to the girl who sells
what?
Flint.
Now I find myself wondering if you're just horribly discreet, or if those mutations completely scrubbed away your curiosity. Are you really not interested in what happened? In what became of me after they cast me out?
Yeah.
Well, since you brought it up, I'd gladly hear the rest. Let's see. They'd escorted you out of the duchy.
Yes. And the noble knights of Toussaint and I didn't stop until we reached the Ketdu wilderness. They left me there alone, without a copper, in a torn lace dress. Right when the frosts were setting in. They assumed something would eat me, or that I'd do everyone a favor and die of hunger. But as always, I failed to live up to expectations. I wandered the woods for a week, went purple from the cold, gnawed the bark from twigs. Finally, I saw a light among the trees. A campsite. They were bandits, bearded, drunk, spattered with blood. I was sure they'd rape me or kill me, or both.
Take it neither happened?
That's when I learned a robber and a murderer can be a better man than a knight in shining armor. They took me in, we set off for Nizia.
Wow, really?
And I did what I could to repay them. I advanced in their ranks rather quickly. Eventually, I became their leader. Of the whole ragged band.
Should have stayed there, maybe.
Perhaps. Perhaps I should have forgotten everything. Started a new life. But you know what? There came a point when I thought, you wanted a monster. Then a monster you shall get.
Yep. That's what happens when you treat somebody like that.
Been through a lot.
I have. And throughout this time, my sister was stomping grapes and shagging minstrels on down bedding.
She wasn't the one to banish you.
And I'm not angry at her for that. I'm angry at her because she forgot about me. Right. We've had our chat. Come.
I want to talk to the girl who sells Flint. See, I'm first. Hang on, we gotta meditate. It's gonna drive me nuts. Okay. Oh, and we need to repair my sword. Okay. I don't get to talk to the three little bears. Frames have gotten bad all of a sudden. Actually, okay, you know what? We're gonna call it here, and then we will optionally talk to the girl who sells Flint in the next one. But I think this one's gone on for a long time. It's hard to tell because I had so many interruptions. But we got all the magic beans, so thank you all for joining me, and next time we'll plant them? I don't know. Anyway, I'll see you next one.